Hello, this is week 5 for Pre-Ballet 1. Rory and Chloe are back here with us, and we just had our Easter weekend. I hope all of you had a lot of fun at home with family this past weekend, and I can't wait to get back in the studio to hear what some of your favorite things were that you did. We had an exciting weekend. Rory, what was your favorite thing that we did over the weekend to celebrate Easter?
We Zoomed with our whole family and we decorated Easter eggs, and I liked that.
I liked that too. It would have been more fun if we could have had our whole family here
with
us. But it was fun seeing everybody on the TV. And Chloe, what was your favorite?
I liked going for an Easter egg hunt.
That was fun too. And you had some favorite hiding spots too, didn't you?
Yes, the wolves.
Yes, Chloe thought it was funny that some of the Easter eggs were taped to the wall of our house, which was pretty silly. That's never happened before. My favorite part of Easter was sitting down with Rory and Chloe and their dad and having Easter dinner together. So we made a big, fancy dinner together. And we're going to have leftovers today.
Yes!
So I have a special story to read for you again today. It's called Tallulah's Tutu, My Maryland Singer. And Tallulah's dance class is a little bit different than our dance class. In our dance class, a lot of you wear a tutu, which is a skirt that you wear for ballet. But Tallulah's dance teacher, they have special tutus, kind of like the one that Rory is wearing. And they have to earn their tutu by spending lots of time practicing and getting really good at their ballet moves. And when they get really, really good at their ballet class, then they are given a tutu by their teacher. So we're going to read a story about Tallulah, and we're going to hear about some of the dance moves that she learns as she goes through the story. So we're going to start here. This is before it even starts. If you can see the pictures, this is Tallulah practicing all of her feet positions. I think Rory and Chloe know these positions. There's first position, second position, third position, fourth position, fifth position, and then reverence, that's where you take your bow at the end. Very good. Tallulah's tutu. There's Tallulah again. She looks very excited to get to ballet class. Here we go. All right. Tallulah just knew she could be a great ballerina if only she had a tutu. And maybe a lesson or two, her mother said with a wink. I think her mother is pretty smart. Look at Tallulah looking in the window at the tutu with her little brother. So the next day, Tallulah went to her very first ballet class. The kids wore leotards and pink tights, all except one. He had on black pants. A boy in ballet? Well, he won't get a tutu, Tallulah giggled. I've had some boys in my ballet classes. Ballet's for boys, too. Are you with us? Tallulah asked her teacher. Tallulah said, yes, I am with you. Tallulah decided she'd better pay attention. She watched closely. She turned out her feet and curved her hands near her hips in first position. She bent her knees in a plie. She did it perfectly. Plie means to bend, remember. I am an excellent ballerina, she thought, and soon I'll get a tutu, just like one. At the end of class, the teacher told them what a good job they had done. Tallulah waited for her tutu. But instead, she got a big hug. Good job, said her teacher. Tallulah decided that her tutu must be coming from Paris. They would fly it in next week. What do you think, Chloe? Do you think that's why she didn't get her tutu?
No.
No. Why do you think Tallulah didn't get her tutu this week?
Because I don't really know.
What do you think, Rory?
Because she didn't do a good job.
Well, maybe she's just not ready yet. Maybe it's not that she did a bad job. Maybe it's just that it takes a lot of practice and she needs a little more time. You think? Tallulah practiced every day. "Look at my beautiful arms," she said on the way to class. "Look at my perfect finish." Beautiful arms are very important, aren't they?
Yes.
Rory's still working on her arms. Tallulah grinned a big grin as she stood at the bar. "What color tutu do you want?" she asked the girl in front of her. "I want lavender." She pointed to some September asters blooming outside the window. September asters are a purple flower. "Tallulah, look in the mirror. Can you make your back straighter?" her teacher said. Tallulah could. She jumped her heels apart to second position. She pointed her toe in tendu. She circled her foot on the floor in a rond de jambe. Rond de jambe means round movement of the leg. "I am a fabulous ballerina," Tallulah told herself. "I'm gonna get my tutu right after class." Chloe, do you have a prediction? Do you think she's gonna get her tutu this time? Mm-hmm. No, why not?
Because she's not ready. She hasn't had enough prep.
I think that's a very good prediction, Chloe. But this time, all she got was a kiss on the top of her head. "Keep it up, Tallulah. You're doing very well," said her teacher. Tallulah figured the delivery truck broke down. Her tutu must be stuck in New Jersey. They would drive it in next week. What do you think, Rory? Do you think her tutu's stuck in New Jersey?
No.
No, I think she's just making up excuses. At home, Tallulah showed her mother everything she had learned. Her little brother Beckett watched. Then she practiced some more. "Good job, Tallulah. I'm so glad she's practicing at home." At her third lesson, Tallulah could hardly keep still. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, she sang to the boy next to her. "A tunic for you, a tutu for me." She whirled around and bumped his leg. "Tallulah, stay in your own space, please," her teacher said. "Whoops," Tallulah said. She shifted one foot in front of the other in third position. She pointed one foot against her other knee in passé. She did a relevé by standing on her toes. "I'm the best ballerina in the world," Tallulah said to herself. "Today I'll get my tutu for sure." What do you think? Not yet? I know you two have both been taking classes in ballet for a long, long time. It takes a lot of practice to earn your tutus. But there was no tutu for Tallulah. No tutu at all. "Where is it?" she asked her teacher. "Where is what?" "My tutu." "Tallulah." Her teacher leaned down and put her arms around her. "You have to wait a while, Tallulah, and it takes a lot of time and a lot of practice to earn your tutu." Tallulah stomped her foot. It did not feel good to do that in a ballet slipper. "That's not fair," she cried. "A ballerina needs a tutu, and she needs it now." Wow, Tallulah is not a very patient little girl, is she? Not at all. Tallulah decided she wasn't going to practice any more ballet. She told her mother that she wasn't going to show her any more steps. Sounds like Tallulah's getting pretty angry. We have a grumpy Tallulah. And she wasn't going to go to class ever again. "Really?" said her mother. "But I thought you loved ballet." "I love ballet," said Beckett, her little brother, even though he'd never even taken a class. "Well, I don't. I'm not even going to think about ballet anymore," Tallulah declared. Do you really think that's what's going to happen?
No.
What's your prediction? Do you think she's going to not even think about ballet, Chloe? I have a sneaky suspicion ballet is still going to be in her head. But everything kept reminding Tallulah of ballet. Her neighbor's dog always stood in second position. The kitchen clock constantly performed rendezvous. The serving spoon at dinner was forever doing tendus. And everywhere she went, Tallulah couldn't help dancing ballet. That sounds like two little girls I know. She always did a plie when she petted the neighbor's dog. And she couldn't go by a store window without doing a beautiful finish. Or pass a park bench without using it as a bar. Then one day at the supermarket, she heard tinkly music over the loudspeakers. It was the same music the pianist played in her ballet class. Tallulah couldn't stop herself. Passes, releves, tendus, she did them all. She pirouetted around the store. Do we have anyone back here who knows how to do a pirouette? Good job, beautiful. I know it's hard on this rug. When she finished, the shoppers applauded. Except for one girl. She was wearing a lavender tutu. I want to dance like that, she said. I've already got the tutu. Maybe you need a lesson or two. Or 22, said Tallulah. And lots of practice as well. She looked at her mother and winked. I think Tallulah finally learned her lesson. She needs to do a lot of practicing to earn her tutu. The next day, she went back to class. I'm glad to see you, Tallulah, said her teacher. Tallulah beamed. I'm glad to see you too, she said. Then she took her place at the bar. I am a very, very good dancer, she thought, and I will get my tutu someday. And she did, except it wasn't lavender. It was as red as the roses blooming that June. So sometimes things don't turn out exactly as you expect, but they turn out really well all the same. And there Tallulah is again in first position. First position, second position, third position, fourth position, fifth position, and reverence. Very good. That was our story of Tallulah. And now we're going to do some dancing with you, which we always, always, always have to start the same way with the very first thing you always do before you dance, Chloe.
Warm
up. And why do we always warm up before we dance?
We don't injure ourselves.
Right, so that our muscles are ready to move. I know some of you may have been sitting around a little bit today and not moving those muscles as much as you should. So we're going to warm them up so we don't get any injuries. So let's come down to our butterfly. Glue your feet together. Bounce those knees up and down and say, wake up legs.
Wake up legs.
Wake up. And let's rock back and forth like a boat. Ready? You girls going to sing with me?
Oh, sure.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Back to the center, let's take our nose to our toes and count to eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Sit up. I feel like I was the only one. Nose to toes, and let's count to eight. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Sit up. And can I see your pretty ballerina posture? Sit up straight, tall. And now let me see yucky ballerina posture. And sit up straight and tall with pretty ballerina posture. And yucky ballerina. And sit up straight and tall. Very good. Let's practice moving our arms. Bring your arms up and out to first, second, fifth, first, and down. Very good. Let me see if I can trick you. Ready? Second, first, second, first.
Oh, I tricked you.
Fifth, first, fifth, first, second, and down.
Very good. Good job, Chloe.
Take those arms down, put those fingertips and those arms behind you. Press those legs straight out in front of you. Let's work our feet. Point and flex. Point and flex. Point and flex. Ready for our head, shoulders, knees, and toes song? Here we go.
Head, shoulders, knees, and toes. Knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes. Knees and toes. Eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes.
Good job. Shake out those legs. Shake, shake, shake. Bend your knees and let's stomp on the ground. Stomp, stomp, stomp. Freeze your legs and see if you can lift your bottoms up off the ground into a tabletop. And we're going to try something pretty hard. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
We're going to try to lift one leg up off the ground and hold it straight up in the sky. And then let's see if we can switch and lift the other leg up into the air and bring it down. Bottoms down and let's shake out those arms. Woo! Good job, everyone. Very good. And come up onto your knees and drum on your lap. Good job. Ready? Let's work our arms again. Let's see if I can trick you again. I didn't trick you, I tricked Rory. Ready? Here we go. First, second, fifth, second, first, second, fifth, second, first, fifth, first, ooh, almost right. Fifth, second, and down. Very good job. And when you move your arms like that, that's called a port de bras. That's a movement of your arm. Ready? Bottoms up, bottoms down. Bottoms up, arms out for balance. Step one foot forward and bring it back down. Step your other foot forward and bring it back down. Bottoms down. I know, that was tricky. That was something new today. Let's try it again. Ready? Bottoms up, arms in second. One foot forward, one foot down. Other foot forward, other foot down. Bottoms down. Very good. And let's go ahead, take it all the way up to our toes this time. Bottoms up, arms to fifth, one foot forward, stand up tall, all the way up onto your tippy toes and touch the sky. Bend your knees and touch the ground. And stand up tall and touch the sky. Bend your knees. Stand up tall and touch the sky. Jump up and down, jump as high as you can. Good job, jump side to side. Shake those wiggles out. Hop like a bunny. And down, very good. Now it's time for our ballet part of the class. So if you have a chair to use or a bar to use, go ahead and get the bar and bring it out to your dance space or the chair. Remember you can use the back of the chair. Thank you, Chloe. Oh, we ran over Chloe. All right, so do you two want to stand closer or further away from the bars? Closer. So, okay, so I'll take a step back. And let's put all of our feet in first position. And Rory, I'm going to ask you to go ahead and just start the music. Today, instead of me teaching you the set and then doing it to music, we're going to try to put everything together that we did the first 4 weeks and try to follow along with the music. So are we ready?
Yep.
Okay, feet in first. Let's plie one. Releve up one, two, three. On the last one, hold those toes up high. If you can, bring your arms up to first position. Stay on those toes. See if you can find your balance here. Good job. Bring it back down. Plie one, two, three, four. This time we're going to saute to second. First, second, first, second. One more time, stay in second. Four pliés, one, two, three, four. Releve up, one, two, three. Hold it high, arms to the front. See if you can find your balance. Can you stay up high on those tippy toes in second position? Take it down, saute first, second, first, second, first, second. One more time to first. Good job. Let's tendu, passe, make a triangle, tendu, and close. Other side, tendu, passe, tendu. And close. Other side again. Tendu. Passe. Make a triangle. Tendu. And close. Other side. Tendu. Passe. Tendu. And close. Push your right foot forward and tap. Tap that toe. Four, three, two. Let's lift and lower. Lift, lower. Lift nice and slow. Control. Lift, lower back to first. Same leg to the side. Tap that toe. Tap, tap, tap. Good. Right here. Lift, lower. Lift, lift. One more time. Lift. Bring it back to first. Good job. And we're going to take our other toe and push it forward, and we're gonna tap, tap, tap that toe. Our music's gonna come right back. We're gonna catch the music. There it is. All right, now we're gonna take this toe, lift and lower. Nice and slow, lift and lower. Lift and lower. Lift and lower. Let's try it to the side. Tap, tap, tap to the side, same way. Our next song a little bit. So we only have four different moves that we're gonna do, and we're gonna start by hopping in place. So both feet, you'll just jump. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. But then we're gonna repeat that. We're gonna hop again, but instead of facing you, we're gonna hop to the side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now we're gonna hop to the back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Hop to the other side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then back to the front. So that's our first move. For our second move, we're gonna jog in place. So you all know how to jog, right? we jog in circles or we run around the block, we run around, hopefully you don't run too much around the house. Well, you don't have a lot of space at home, and we don't have a lot of space here, especially with three of us. So we're gonna jog right in place, facing the camera for 8 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we're gonna turn and face the mirror. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Turn and face the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Face the front. For our last movement, our arms will come to the side and we're gonna do our batmas. Kick 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll kick 8 times to the front, 8 times to this side, 8 times to the back, 8 times to this side, and then we'll face the camera again and start over with our bunny hops. Now this is a high energy song. Do you think you all can keep up with us? We shall see. Now be careful when we do our batmas, Chloe and Rory, you might want to take a step behind me so that when we kick to the side, we're not kicking each other, okay? Rory, could you go ahead and put on that song from Trolls that's next on the playlist? It's from the new Trolls movie, The World Tour. Not Rainbows and Unicorns. That's the one. 5, 6, 7, hop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, to the mirror. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, to the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, to the front. Jog in place. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Back. 2, 3, 4. I like how you're pointing your toes as you're jogging. 7, 8. Side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to the front. Batmas. Kick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Don't kick your sister to the back. 1. I like how you're getting into the music, Chloe. 4, 5, 6, 7, to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Back to the front. Back to our hops. Here we go. Hop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, to the back. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, to the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, jog to the front, jog. 5, 6, 7, to the mirror. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, to the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to the front. Batmas. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. take your bow, don't kick your mom. All right, can you stop the music for us, please? And I had a couple more songs prepared for you, but we are all out of time today. I'm so glad you joined us again this week for dance class, and I hope to see you all next week for week 6. I can't wait to get back in the studio with you, but for now, keep practicing at home. Bye, we miss you.
Bye.